Hello, in this video we're going to be doing a setup using our SunMotion Yi AC servo system, and we do have our EtherCAT interface amplifier with a 10 amp capacity, and we also going to run this amplifier with a single phase and 200 volts AC. I have my servo motor as well with a flange size of 40 millimeters. It doesn't have a brake. And it has a barrel-less absolute encoder with a 23-bit resolution and a rated output of 50 watts. Right here, I do have my encoder connector, which is going to be attached in X3 in my amplifier. Then I have also my power connector on my servo motor. Right here in the right side, I do have the wiring diagrams. Red, it's for U. White, it's for V, and black, it's for W. We're going to be connecting this connector to XV. And do not forget to connect the ground wire to the chassis of the amplifier. Then right here, I do have my two main power supply connectors. XA, it's for my main power supply on my amplifier, and XC, it's my main power for my control. I'm using a single phase, therefore we're gonna be connected L1 and L2 in XA, and then we do have two jumpers for 1LC and L2C. I'm using my adapter to connect and disconnect my wires. And right now, do not forget to connect the ground wire to the chassis of the amplifier as well. We're going to be also needing our USB 0 adapter to connect it in X0 through our computer and open our SunMotion setup software. We're going to go ahead and turn on our transformer that we are using. This transformer is 220 to 240 volts. And we're looking to not have any alarms, and this H shape in the digital should be displayed. We're going to go ahead and click on communication settings. Then we're going to go ahead and click on add access and connect. Green dot, good. We're going to go ahead and exit. Now in the left side, I do have different tabs, but we're going to be focused a little bit more on parameters in each group. Watch this window, and right here, this is my parameters or my amplifier, and we're gonna look at ID01. This is for my main circuit. Make sure you select the one that you're using. I'm using a single phase. Click OK, and in the right side, I do have my standard parameters. System 2, it's for my parameters on my motor, and we need to look or pay attention to ID02. We gotta make sure we do have this enabled because this is the automatic setup on my motor, which is a great function. We exit because it's activated. Now ID05 to 8 are very important as well. And don't forget, we do have our standard parameters in the right side as well. Then we're gonna be looking at group 9. Group 9, it's basically for our extended functions. These are basically safety functions that we're able to select. Once we have select all the parameters that we want, we're going to go ahead and click on writing amplifier, exit the window, disconnect our amplifier, and turn down the system. In this case, my transformer. After that, we're gonna turn it back on. Check that we do not have any alarms on my amplifier, which is good right now, and double click on the software side to reconnect the amplifier to our software. Green amplifier means connection completed. Now I'm gonna do a test operation and click on jog operation. Okay. Right here, I do have two operation system and two stop methods. My servo is ready, and I'm able to monitor our torque, position, and velocity. If I wanna change these parameters, I click on edit, and change it to 250, make a decision, servo on, positive direction, great, negative direction, good, let's try it again, positive, negative, it seems my motor is running properly, servo off, and I'm gonna exit. When we have an alarm, we're gonna sit in the display in our amplifier, as well a red dot in the software side. We click on diagnose and alarm history. Right here, we're able to see the alarm code, name, and the time this alarm was generated. Click on diagnosis. We do have the same information here, but right here, we're able to select, we're gonna have one or different options at the time this alarm was generated. We choose the right one, and down here we're gonna be able to see the cause and the steps we need to follow in order to clear those alarms. We're able to see this information in a manual as well. I'm gonna go ahead and exit, and this time I need to clear alarm reset. Okay, alarm successfully done. Good, I'm gonna exit. I do not have an alarm on my software side nor on my amplifier. And this is the setup using our SunMotion G series. Thank you.